What up everyone, welcome back to the channel. Jahmal here, and in today's video we're going to be continuing our Appium series. So in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can connect Appium to a real iOS device and get started with setting up your desired capabilities. So let's get started. Alright, so the first thing I want to do is just head over to my React Native Starter project. And what I'm going to do is navigate down towards the bottom. I'm looking for the iOS folder. And I'm just going to open up the React Native Starter XE workspace. All right, once that's loaded, you just want to go to your targets. And then you just want to click sign in and capabilities. Make sure automatically manage sign in is checked. And the team, you have to choose your name or personal team. If you don't have one, just click add an account. Very simple. You just want to click cancel right here and just click the plus button, Apple ID, and just click continue. And this is where you're going to put in that new Apple ID if you needed to get started. But since I have an Apple ID, everything is good. I'm just going to go back. Alright, so I'm just going to make sure that's set to my name. And I'm just going to make sure my iPhone is selected, my real iPhone, not a simulator. And once that's done, I'm just going to make sure the React Native Starter target is highlighted. And I'm just going to click the play or build button. So the app is going to build. It's going to take some time. But once that's done, we'll come right back and we'll fire it up on our iPhone device. All right, now the app is successfully built. It just pushed the app onto my device. So that's good. So now it's telling us it's not trusted on this device as yet. So we're going to fix that problem. Right now we're just going to click OK. And what you want to do is just hop over to your phone, click settings, click cancel real quick. And all I'm going to do is go to general, scroll down towards the bottom, and I'm just going to click device management. And then you're going to click Apple development. So right here you're going to click the trust Apple development with your sign in ID. And this one is going to trust it. So that's good. So now that's trusted and that's good, we can fire up the app. And now just want to ask you for permission to use your local network. Just click OK. And there you have it. Now we have our React Native app on our real device. Next thing I want to do is just simply, I'm just going to dismiss this. Oops. So what I'm going to do next is just going to fire up Appium, start up the server. And we're just going to get started with building the desired capabilities. All right, so I'm just going to close this workspace. And what I'm going to do is just start up my Appium server. So now that it's launched, what I'm going to do is just search for Appium Inspector in Launchpad. So just type in Appium and you're just going to see Inspector. So double click on that. Let's get that fired up. Alright, now that we have our inspector loaded, I currently don't have any desired capabilities. I deleted the previous one, so we're just going to be starting from scratch. And in order to get started, we are going to need to open up our Xcode. And what you want to do is go to Windows, scroll down to Devices and Simulators, and you're going to click that. And you should see your iPhone device already populated. On to the right, you're going to see all the useful information that we're going to need, such as the iOS, the model, identifier, bundler ID, all that good stuff. All right, so let's just hop back over to our inspector, and we're just going to start building our desired capabilities. All right, so the first thing we're going to start off with is platform name. So let's type our platform name. And in this case, we're going to be using iOS, so that's going to be our value. Next, what we need is a platform version. So we'll go back over to my Xcode and my devices and simulator screen. Oh, not that. Let me minimize that. You can see that I'm running on 14.3. So I'm just going to put 14.3 right here. Make this smaller so I can make everything in view. I'm just going to add the next capability, and in this case what we're going to do is give it an automation name. So since we're using our test in an iOS device, this is going to be XCUI test. So just let's enter that value right there. And next we're going to add another one, and in this case what we need to have is the device name. So that's what we're going to type, the device name. And the device I'm using, we can go over to the right, I'm using an iPhone 8 Plus, so I'm just going to type iPhone 8 Plus. All right, that looks good. So now what I need to add is another capability, and in this case it's going to be the bundle ID. So the bundle ID is pretty much the app package name. So we can find this over here again. So it's under the identifier. So it's the org react.js native example react native starter 1. So I'm just going to type that into the value for my bundle ID, because I can't copy it right at the moment. So I'm just going to type this out. All right, back check, make sure everything looks good. All right, looks good. And now I'm just going to add another capability. So we have the bundle ID. The next one that we have to use is going to call the Xcode organization ID, or org ID. And I'm just going to type Xcode org ID. In order to find this value, we have to go up to our spotlight search, and we're going to do a search for keychain access. So type in keychain access, and once that loads, you should be on the login tab, and move over to my certificates. And once you're under my certificate, you should see your Apple development certificate for that Apple ID. Double click on that, and what you're going to look for is the organizational unit. So you're going to copy this code or digit, this value, and you're just going to insert it into your Appium. This is a sensitive ID, so I will be blurring most of this out, but you will get the gist of it. So the next one we're going to have is going to be an Xcode signing ID, and this pretty much is going to be an iPhone developer, and that's pretty much the common and standard value. So we're just going to type in iPhone developer, and let the last capability that we're going to need is the UDID, and this is just the identifier of that real device. So we hop back over to our devices and simulator. On the identifier, we're going to just copy this long hash code, I'm guessing this unique code, and you're just going to paste that value in there. And now we're just going to make sure that we have all of our capabilities, so everything looks good. What you want to do is just click save as. And I'm just going to name this iPhone 8 Plus Caps, if I can spell iPhone. iPhone 8 Plus Caps. All right, that looks good. And what we're going to do, make sure we have our Appium server running. Put that to the side. And what we're going to do now is just start the session. All right, Appium make connection. We see some logs happening right here, so let's just give our device some time so it could there we go. So React Native just launched onto the device. It was installed successfully. Seems like we about to have interaction with the device, and now we can inspect our elements. And this is what we wanted. You know, we just wanted the ability to just push our app to a real iOS device, and there it is. We can now look at our elements, inspect it, have that reliability of testing on a real device opposed to emulators, so you know that there's no issues when you push your app into production. And this is really, really good. If you guys did like this video, smash the like button. I will drop another video, a part 2, where I set up the desired capabilities within Java inside my IDE, which is Eclipse, so you can see how we can run Appium and connect to our iPhone through Eclipse and Java. But if you guys did like this video, you know, smash that like button. If you have any issues, drop a comment below, and I'll definitely reach back to you and give you some assistance. But that's all I have. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in another video. Have a good night.